Hello everybody, Jackson here, and today I'd like to read another bullshit Guardian fucking article, because the Guardian, they're the guardians of fucking sacred knowledge. The knowledge of dumbs, the knowledge of regressives, the knowledge of fucking those that would separate us, those that would identify us all by color, by sex, by creed, by whatever the fuck. Put us in our little groups to fit in their boxes. Anyway, this is an article written by Chela Ramanan. I don't know if I'm saying that correctly. I apologize if I'm not, but honestly, lady, your last name just makes me want to eat some fucking ramen noodles. Okay. Though, she's got a problem, though. She's got a big problem. Big problem with the industry, the video game industry. It's so big, this is such a problem that it's in the Guardian's home tech page in games.
Okay.
You might be asking yourself, oh, I wonder what she's going to be talking about, right? Like, maybe you'll find her talking about day one DLC that's cut content and season passes that are almost as much as the base version of the game. Microtransactions that exist to, you know, feed the gambler and feed the addiction that people have from getting that high, you know. These things you may expect to hear. But not from the Guardian. No, Chela has a much bigger problem, see? Because the video game industry has a diversity problem. But it can be fixed. Despite corrective initiatives, there are too few gaming industry opportunities for women and people of color. This needs to change if it is to have a healthy future. So based on that little tidbit and the following picture that says still a man's world ... the E3 gaming expo in Los Angeles, and it's just a bunch of white guys because they're the racists, they're the ones that are focusing on people's color of skin. Anyway, based on that, like that picture with that headline, she's trying to be provocative. Honestly, part of me thinks this bitch is a troll. Because this, you know, but then she goes on, like, I'm not even going to be able to, I will have the link to this article, please feel free to go read it. Honestly, she makes some good points, but in the wrong area of thinking. She thinks that, you know, it's black people, women, and like, you know, people of color, all these people, that they need access to more, you know, information, more opportunities within the tech field. That's not what I think. I think she's right, but I think it's a community thing. I think it's that poorer communities. Because guess what, lady? I'm fucking white. Okay? I'm white and I'm broke. I'm poor as fuck, okay? I've never been to college. Never had money for it. Parents didn't have money for it, alright? Never been to college, okay? So you fucking factor into that, okay? But you know what? I'm white. I'm a male. I like to bang women. Right? So I should, by your logic, I should be able to get a fucking, you know, job in the gaming industry over a qualified female or a qualified person of color, right? That's what you think based on this article. That's why I think she's a troll, because this logic is just fucking out there, man. But then she says, like, incredibly racist shit, you know, and sexist shit. And then she's, you know, about the people that are supposedly the racists and the sexists. And it makes no sense to me. These people's fucking, this thinking that we all need to be in little bubbles, we all need to be part of some little individual victim collective, is just pissing me off. Just stop it, okay? Just fucking stop it. And you know, I'm not gonna tackle these ideas on a day-to-day basis on my channel, but when you start to fuck with my goddamn toys, lady, and the people who are making my fucking toys, well then you've crossed a line into where which I will defend them and this hobby and this thing I love. Because it's not this horrible picture that you're painting it out to be. And the people who exist within it aren't these horrible, fucking hateful, racist, sexist people that you would have us believe that they are. Glance at last year's big releases and you might think video games have cracked the issue of diversity. Two of 2016's most acclaimed action adventures, Mafia 3 and Watch Dogs 2, both had black male leads. You know what's funny is I didn't even know that. I honestly didn't even know that. I'd never thought about that. The only thing I know about Mafia 3 is I watched Joe's review. I never thought the dude is black. I never thought that. I just didn't. And this Watch Dogs 2, honestly, I haven't watched shit on that, but I know that the lead character in that was black. But the Mafia 3 one, when I was reading that, I was just like, wow. While Mirror's Edge 2, Uncharted 4, and Indie Game Virginia all featured women of color. Didn't know that either, right? Didn't know that. Because I'm not counting fucking quotas over here. I'm looking at the characters in the game, not the fucking skin color of them. You know? And that's the thing that these people don't understand, is they are the fucking... They think they're like some fucking radical fucking thinkers that are solving all the world's fucking racist and fucking corruption problems. No, you're hurting it. You're making it worse. Okay? This year we have flagship PlayStation 4 title Horizon Zero Dawn, as well as Gravity Rush 2, Nier Automata, and Tacoma, all showcasing female protagonists. Yeah, and that's a good thing, right? You know what I love about Horizon Zero Dawn? This is what I love about this game. Is you go through it and you see, you know, a lot of diversity and skin color and things like that. And you know what the best part about it is? Is it's all tribal, man. It was back when it wasn't about fucking, you know, what you looked like. It was about where you were from and what your ideals were, all right? And these fucking people, you know, like, you go through this world in this game as Aloy, as a female protagonist that is an interesting character, that is a well-written character, and you realize that it's not about that. It's not about filling some bullshit quota like this bitch, all right? That's not what it is. These people are perceiving a post-apocalyptic future that might be brighter than the world that we currently inhabit because of people like you. Chella. But look beyond the games and into the companies that make them, and you get a very different picture. Representation is still very much a problem. In an age where a whole generation is taking its cultural cues and influences from games, this is vital importance even outside of the industry. Video games now make $90 billion a year worldwide, dwarfing cinema and movie businesses, of course. According to figures from industry trade, blah, 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 50% of UK plays the games, blah, blah, blah. I'm sorry, I just, 99% among 8, 15-year-olds, you throw math at me and I'm like, okay, so she must know what she's talking about. I don't know, this could be right. A lot of people play games, as well as a surge in young people seeking to work in the industry, yes. That is a good point. Over 60 UK universities provide undergraduate and master's degrees in games development. But who are the people guiding this inspirational and pervasive culture? Pervasive cultural sector. Sorry, I left a word out because I've read this so many times at this point that my head hurts. That's why I'm not even gonna fucking read the whole thing. Okay? Put it this way. This is racist. What this bitch just is about to say is racist and sexist, okay? I don't fucking care, alright? I don't care if she's a woman of color. I don't give a fuck, okay? Don't give a fuck. She says, put it this way, if you live in the West and work in games, you're probably white, straight, male, and middle class. Because she's not seeing game devs. She's not seeing game devs. She's not seeing people who are creating video games. All she's seeing is color and dicks. Right? But they are the sexist ones. They are the racist ones. Right? Because they decided to go to college to fucking get a degree in games development and go in there and fucking show that they could do it, prove that they had ideas, prove they could do the job, right? They're the fucking racists and sexists because they did that. They took that action with their life and paddled their own goddamn canoe down the course of the river that they wanted to go down. Right? Ron for life. Ron for president. Put it this way. If you live in the West and work in games, you're probably white, straight, male, and middle class. The latest figures from game industry's trade body, TIGA, shows that just 14% of people working in the UK games industry are women. The ratio is more or less the same in the US. Because it matters. It matters. You know, and the woman who is there, you know, who went through and did this the right way and took the time to become a game developer, you know, wanted that career and earned it and is making great games because there's tons of women making amazing fucking video games. There's tons of women who can play video games who do it, right? And they're growing up and now, and it's not like when we were kids when it was all directed towards boys, right? Even though one could argue that there were strong female heroes back then, going back to the NES days. But moving past that, I'm just saying that, you know, it was obviously marketed towards boys. But now you've got characters like Aloy, you know, games like that are marketed towards girls, that are, you know, going to get a girl's attention, right? But it's still not good enough because the people who made it may have been, you know, how did she put it? White, straight, male, and middle class. So there's no merit in that game, right? Unless all the people who made that game are female and different colored people than white, right? Then that game has no merit. What they're fucking saying in that game, what the message is, that it's bullshit, right? It's all crap because it's coming from white men. White men can't have good ideas. You fucking racist cunt. Looking at the most recent figures, the picture is pretty depressing when considering ethnic diversity. A creative skill set report shows that BAME, Black, Asian, and Minority Ethic, industry representation stood at 4% in 2015, down from 4.7% the previous year. This is lower than the UK average of 10%, significantly lower than the London average, 40%, 2011. See, so this isn't racism, dumbass. It comes down to class, opportunity. All right. Like I said, I'm poor. I'm from an area where not a lot of people have a whole lot of money. Okay. And the ones that do live on a fucking hill. Okay. So, you know, I don't have a whole lot of opportunity. Does that mean that I'm oppressed? Can I be a fucking victim now? No. Or can we just work out a way that I could have gone to college so that fucking someday someone down the line who's in my position when I was younger can actually do it? I don't give a fuck what color they are. And I don't give a fuck what's swinging between their legs or not. Swinging between their legs. Doesn't matter. And that's how I feel a lot of video games. These fucking, you know, they're the racists, they're the sexists. I don't care. They can try to fucking cast the blame onto us and paint us in this horrible picture all they want, but it's not fucking flying. My bullshit meter's going haywire. And I think part of the reason that my bullshit meter is going so fucking crazy is this last little bit that I'm going to share, and then I want to talk about why I wanted to cover this story on my channel. Because I'm not going to be getting into this SJW bullshit, alright? I'm just not. It's not something I want to be doing, okay? But this is different, and I need to explain why after this. Because this is a way of thinking that's fucking stupid, and I don't want it involved in my fucking video games, okay? I'm sorry, I don't. I don't want this type of thinking involved there. Okay, I want to read this little bit here. I'm going to have a link to this article, of course. You can go read the whole thing if you want. She makes some good points, but like I said, her view is askew because she's a racist, because she is a sexist, okay? If you're a feminist who thinks that, you know, it's about equality, I promise you it's not, never been about equality to these people. It's not about equality, okay? It's not. So here it goes. There is also a problem of culture. The mainstream industry has spent years pandering to a hardcore demographic of young men. But when aspects of that audience indulge in abusive and threatening behavior online, via social media and gaming forums, there's very little comeback from the major publishers. So basically, I guess what she's saying there is anytime some petulant 12-year-old uses a bad word online to describe groups of people or fucking women or anything like that, some petulant little 12-year-old troll who's doing that to get a rise out of people like you because it's fucking hilarious when you get all fucking indignant and shit and act like you're holier than thou and better than the rest of us because you fucking have the right way of thinking that everyone belongs in little groups and blah, blah, blah. Anyway. Anytime any 12-year-old does that, EA, Ubisoft, Activision, you motherfuckers, you gotta get on fucking the interwebs and you gotta do a public decry. Decrying that nameless fucking person that is probably a 12-year-old troll who did it just to get that rise. And you know what's gonna happen, you crazy, crazy bitch? Is that's just going to continually happen. Okay, you understand what I'm saying? Because then they realize, oh wow, I can be famous if I say some fucking hateful shit. And you've not helped the problem at all, bitch. Because you won't let any of that shit go. We gotta talk about it all the time. We gotta make sure that we, you know, we gotta count colors. We gotta count fucking dicks. We gotta count pussies, right? We can't just count fucking good ideas. Hard work. No, that doesn't matter. Here we go. Now, this is a quote from someone else. Gamergate is an example of the shortcomings, says Dami Lola Odelola, founder of another diversity initiative, Black Girl Tech, which provides free workshop introducing black women to technology, including virtual reality and coding, which is good. There was a public outcry, but the issue wasn't addressed properly by the industry. The reaction felt superficial. Okay, here's the thing about Gamergate, okay? And why you can't take anything in this fucking article serious. Gamergate had nothing to do with a bunch of assholes online talking shit. Okay, that was just the narrative that these bullshit fuckers spun. What Gamergate had to do with was journalists within the games media giving glowing reviews for dick suckings. Giving money to games developers whose games they have given good reviews to. Money! While also fucking them. That is prostitution. If I go fuck a woman and then immediately afterwards I give her a $400 fur coat, what is that? What do you think the cops would do with that? Right? And these are the people that we, as gamers, are getting our news from about video games. And we're supposed to be like, okay, don't worry, they'll tell us the truth. And when we know that if someone sucks their dick good, they'll fucking give them, you know, them and their shitty game in quotations, a fucking glowing review. That was what Gamergate was about. And that turned from that into, you know, no, Gamergate was really about how there's, you know, a hardcore demographic of young men when they indulge in abusive and threatening behavior online. You know, we're abusive and threatening online via social media and gaming forums. There's very little comeback from the major publishers. I'd like to come on this bitch's back. Anyway, I just wanted to share that. And now I want to talk about why this way of thinking, her way of thinking, is wrong. It shouldn't be a race issue. It shouldn't be a fucking sex issue. It should be a fucking opportunity issue, right? That affects everyone involved. This shouldn't be about black colors. You know, it's not about that. We're all just fucking monkeys riding a goddamn rock through the fucking universe, all right? And that's why another thing about Horizon Zero Dawn is I often wonder if it wouldn't take an apocalypse to fucking get us to start working together in that way again. Because for some reason we can't just move past this, you know, sex, race, whatever the fuck. We can't move past that and just view us all as people. I think a lot of us do. I think that's how a lot of people, common, normal fucking people are. Don't get me wrong. There's fucking assholes on every side of the spectrum in everything in the world. But you know what I'm going to tell you? There's cool people, there's chill people, there's assholes, and they're fucking cunts. All right? And that's where I draw, that's how I distinguish people in my reality, okay? Now, if I was a video game, okay, now let's say if I was a video game executive and a fucking lesbian woman came in and a fucking straight white male came in, okay? The lesbian woman fucking hands me her application, the straight white male hands me his application. I look at them, the straight white male went to a better college, the straight white male has more experience working in the industry, the straight white male has fucking better, you know, basically just more equipped to handle the fucking job, okay? The lesbian woman is untested, she's fresh out of whatever, you know what I mean, and blah, blah. Who do you think is gonna get that job? Now, is that sexist? If I give that man that job? No, that's merit. That man deserves it because he's paddled his own canoe here. He went through the motions. He did the fucking work and he's more qualified than the lesbian. Okay. Now let's talk about the fucking lady who wrote this art, Chella. Let's talk about Chella. Now it was her way, whoever's in that position, if I'm fucking, you know, a fucking guy hiring the developer to work on my video game that I want to make the most amount of money off of, that I want to be the best product possible, right? She's gonna say, you have to hire the lesbian. That isn't equality, okay? This isn't equality. That's you wanting to be treated better. That's you wanting us to have to fit, them to have to fit, not us, I don't work in the fucking industry, but I'm saying, that's like you wanting them to fucking fill some quota. And it's dumb. It's a dumb way of thinking. Because that takes away from the person who may be more qualified to do the job. And no one gives a fuck what color that person is. No one fucking cares what is between that person's legs. No one fucking cares. Alright? That's not what they're doing. They care about the fucking bottom line. They care about the money. I can't believe this bitch has painted me into this bitch as a troll. This bitch has literally painted me into a fucking corner where I'm defending the fucking industry that I view as the most greedy, fucking corrupt, lying fucking shit. They're scandalous as fuck, right? I'm defending them because this is such a crazy idea that these men who care about money above all bottom line, above all, would not give a woman the opportunity to make a fucking game that could make them money if she was the most qualified and the best fucking person to do the job, who had the best idea for the fucking thing. I'm sorry, I'm not buying it. I'm not buying this reality that you live in, where everything needs to be broken down into fucking quotas, numbers, you know, colors. I'm a human fucking being. You're a human fucking being. We're all human fucking beings, okay? And whoever the best human being is for the job is gonna get the fucking job, because they know that that's gonna get them the fucking money. So get the fuck out of here with this, you know, and like, this is gonna change too. Like, I promise, this will be different later on. Like, in a couple of generations, there will be more women there, because we haven't given these young girls time to catch up, okay? With what was a poor marketing decision on their part. It led to a lot of money, but think of how much money they're making now that girls are also enjoying video games, okay? So they were fucking stupid by marketing only to boys. But now these young girls, they're getting an opportunity to fucking step into shoes like Aloy's, right? Step into these fucking, you know, and what if that inspires them to, and it's going to. It's going to. There will be more female fucking video game designers. There will be more video games made by females. More than there are now, which there already are a ton, and they're all really good. Except for yours, you fucking bitch, and you know who I'm fucking talking about. I haven't even played it. I saw a screenshot of it and said, fuck off. Anyway, I love you guys. I'm done now. Don't fuck with my toys, lady. Don't come over into my fucking yard and fuck my toys. Alright? Don't fucking do it.
The greatest. I am the greatest.
That feels so good!
Point spawning in 15 seconds.
Stop!
Extreme. Who's going to be a triple kill?
If you're king, I'll be